All right, it is time for our weekly Rants and Raves, and I'm going to start with Kelly.
This story came from one of the Patch.com sites. People may know this is an AOL entity, their little community online sites. This one in Milwaukee spoke, the guy who was head of the Milwaukee one, because they're shutting down a lot of the sites. They've been up and down trying to stay in business. There's few around here in this area. But in Milwaukee, they've decided that's one of the ones that are definitely going to shut down by October the 7th, by Monday. Well, here's what the guy raised. All the work that they had done on the Sikh temple shootings, all of the Scott Walker, vote, all of that good journalism goes into the ether because AOL, and therefore Patch, has decided they're not going to keep it. I raise this as a serious rant because we're losing critical pieces of information. And I can remember not long ago when working on Eyes on the Prize, when we were having a hard time finding what was local information at the time because people just threw it out. Newsrooms are throwing out valuable archival material in ways that you can't. And the only thing that saved us on a critical storytelling piece was that one guy who had never shot film would not let the station. He was shooting videotape. He didn't even know what film was. He said, but you can't throw this out. So I think this is a small thing with regard to Patch, but it's a big thing with regard to where is this information going and how do we archive it. And I hope that AOL reverses that decision.
Okay. TJ.
Well, mine's a little on the lighter side. It's about a young woman named Katrina Schifrin, and she made a video this past week at her company's offices in Taiwan, and she filmed what is essentially a video resignation letter to her boss. In fact, I think we have a clip. $13 million hits on YouTube as of a couple of hours ago. She says in the video that she's wasted almost 2 years of energy and time. Energy and time. It was a job, and she got paid for it. Then this past week in the Huffington Post, she wrote a column which said, journalism is dead to me because her boss told her to make deadlines, not art. And then she talked about all of the terrible stories that she had to work on. Dan, I don't know if this is the type of young journalist you're seeing, people who think they can write about anything, and also that they are immune to the business realities of journalism. And she was interviewed this past week, and she said she made the video because it's better to forcibly close one door to easily open another. But I got to tell you, I mean, it sounds like bridge burning to me.
All right, Kara. Well, there's been a lot of headlines since the government shut down. But some have been better, some have been worse, and some have been crazy. We have one. Let's take a look. Yeah, this is Fox News, which across the board is calling it a slim down, not a shutdown. Yes, so I know this. You think, what is this, Jenny Craig? What's going on? And really, I think there's a real negative. There's a real editorial judgment here when you call something a slim down. A slim down is positive. It's like, oh well, they're skipping dessert. This isn't a slim down. This is a shutdown of our government. And they've been doing this across the board. In fact, Jeff, who produces the show, was telling me beforehand that they have actually taken Associated Press copy that they subscribe to and taken out the word shutdown and put in the word slim down. Wow. I don't know how the Associated Press feels about that, but if I was the Associated Press, I wouldn't feel too good.
All right, we only have time for one more. I'll arm Rossi for it, Dan. No,
okay, well, let's see what I can do. I feel very hungry. I'd like some Freedom Fries. I have a rave for David Folkenflik of NPR, who did a very good piece, long analysis. He had a liberal analyst on and a conservative analyst on, taking on the idea of false balance in covering the slim down.
Yeah.
As they were pointing out, this is not Democrats and Republicans unable to get along. This is one faction of the Republican Party in one branch of Congress. And other than that, that's all that's going on. And the media are not doing us a service by making it sound like it's just Democrats and Republicans fighting.
All right. You won that one. Mine'll save for next week. All right, and that is it for Beat the Press. Tell us what you think. Should the media continue to interview the Reverend Eugene Rivers? What do you think of Fox News calling the federal shutdown a slim down? Tell us at beatthepress.org. Monday in Greater Boston, the first in our series on concussions. In conjunction with Frontline's League of Denial, we focus on kids and how some school athletic departments insist on baseline testing for all kids who play sports. We'll have that and more Monday at 7. For all of us, I'm Emily Rooney. Thanks for watching.